Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today we're going to be discussing the difference in between stainless and regular aluminum propellers and which one you may need for your application. As we all know, most of the boats out there under 150 horsepower, they typically come with an aluminum propeller. But the real trick is maybe you need something a little bit more robust. That is where the stainless comes into play. So which one do you need for your application? Well, a good rule of thumb is if you're 125 horsepower or less, you want to go ahead and go with the aluminum prop. Reason being, your higher horsepower engines, 150 and up, like this 225 sitting behind me, they put so much stress on the prop because that is its bite, that is its wheel, that is its tire, that is how it gets traction to move the boat through the water. With an aluminum one, with that much horsepower, it tends to actually bend the actual prop, and that in effect reduces your ratio, so you're going to have a lower top speed. Now the trade-off is, if you put a stainless prop on a lower horsepower engine, the sheer weight of one of these is going to reduce the power of a lower horsepower engine. Whereas an aluminum one, it's easy for it to spin and doesn't sap so much power. Let's say you do have a higher horsepower engine that requires you to get a stainless prop. There's still other decisions that you need to consider as you're going through this. Now, if you're in an offshore condition and there's very little chance of you ever hitting anything, then you can go in with what they call a pressed hub scenario, which is this type here. Now, if you're running in shallower water where you do run the risk of actually hitting something with a prop, then you want to consider one that has an insert. Now, the advantage of this type of setup, it has an insert that is replaceable. So should you strike something, it damages the insert and hopefully not the prop itself or your output shaft. Now, if you're fishing in a shallow area, stainless is definitely the way to go because you're inevitably going to let it dig into the bottom. With a stainless, it can just cut through that without a problem. On the aluminum, it's going to end up eroding it away and causing it to fail way sooner than the stainless unit. Let's talk about some of the advantages that the aluminum props have over the stainless ones. The first one, of course, is the cost difference. On a good size prop, you can expect to pay 3 to 4 times as much as an aluminum one to get to a stainless steel one. Let's talk about some of the disadvantages now with the aluminum prop. First, they're not as strong as a stainless, and in a high horsepower, high RPM scenario, the actual blades are going to bend, and when they do that, it reduces your top end speed because it's changed the ratio by virtue of it bending it down. Now, the way the manufacturers typically compensate for this weakness, they make the blades thicker, and by doing so, that's more drag that they're actually adding on the blade as it goes through the water. Now, if you take a strike on an aluminum one, more than likely it is going to tear one of your blades. That's going to require it either to be replaced or you're going to have to find a very talented repair shop that could actually weld it up and reshape it. So what is the final decision? Well, there really isn't one. It's all determined by how much you want to invest in a prop, how you're going to use your boat, what environment it is going to be in, and the performance level that you're looking for. For most people, an aluminum prop will do just fine, and you could actually have an extra one on board and still not approach the cost of a single stainless one. Now, if you're one of those where you've got a high horsepower, high performance boat, you're gonna have to go with the stainless. The only other decision you'll have to make, do you go with a pressed hub or do you go with a replacement insert for the hub? Now that you've made up your mind as to whether or not you want to go aluminum or stainless, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you still have questions determining which one's going to work best for your application, why don't you give us a call and we can walk you through that process. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net. Stay safe out there and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.